Welcome to Mauritius. In this video, I will take you on an unforgettable journey through some of the best natural attractions of Mauritius. From the mesmerizing seven-colored earth, to the mystical Trou or Cerf crater, and the majestic Lord Shiva statue of Grand Bassin. Get ready for a fascinating tour of some of the most iconic sites this paradise island has to offer. So join me as we dive into the wonders of Mauritius. It's coming up. Hi fellow travelers, Ken from Ken Travel 360 here. Back in November, we spent 10 days in Mauritius for a tropical holiday, and we rented a car for the first couple of days of the trip. Driving in Mauritius is easy as they drive on the left side of the road, much like in the UK. It's a convenient and fantastic way to explore the island at your own pace. We're now closing in on our first stop. We're driving up from the town Cupid to a geological marvel, Trou or Cerf. It's a volcanic crater that offers a glimpse into the island's fascinating geological history, and is one of the island's most famous natural landmarks. Mauritius was born from the eruption of volcanoes around 9 million years ago. Nowadays, there is no more volcanic activity here, but the landscape still bears the mark of its geological history. Now here we are standing at the edge of the Trou or Cerf crater. Trou means hole in French, and here we're staring at a big hole of 100 meters deep with a diameter of 350 meters. Also known as Mers volcano, this volcanic crater is at the altitude of 605 meters, so it's a bit cooler here than the coast. Surrounding this dormant volcanic giant is a sea of lush green, a testament to nature's reclamation. Cupid is right in the middle of the central plateau of Mauritius, so from the viewpoint up here, you have a spectacular view over most of Mauritius. Down there, there's Cupid, and there's the Hong Park Mountain and the Trois Mamelles, Port Louis and the Mocha Mountain Range. The name Trois Mamelles translates to the three breasts in English, and is so named because the mountain range has three distinct peaks that somehow resemble three breasts when viewed from certain angles. If you haven't already noticed, Mauritius is a fantastic destination for drone videography. It has relatively drone-friendly regulations, and the island is blessed with breathtaking natural beauty, like pristine beaches with crystal clear waters and lush green mountains. Flying a drone allows you to capture stunning aerial views of these landscapes.
Look at it, the drone is just up there.
During this trip, I was able to practice my newly purchased DJI Mini 4 Pro. I've got more videos featuring these drone shots, so be sure to subscribe if you want to see more. Next, we'll drive to Chamarel, home to the mesmerizing seven-colored earth attraction. The drive up to Chamarel is absolutely beautiful with the winding roads up the mountain. On our way up, we stopped at a scenic viewpoint, treating ourselves to the panoramic vistas. You have the majestic Hong Park Mountain on the right, while on the left, you can find the offshore island, Ile Benetier. The island is a popular day trip for those who are staying on the west coast of Mauritius. You get to enjoy stunning views of the surrounding ocean and the nearby landmarks, and the calm and shallow waters around the island are perfect for snorkeling and other aqua activities. Afterwards, we continued our drive to Chamarel, and eventually we reached the car entrance of Seven Colored Earths. This is where we pay for the admission, which interestingly is different between foreigners and residents. So we're now at the entrance of Seven Colored Earths of Chamarel. So this is the Chamarel Seven Colored Earth, and it's a beautiful geological phenomenon that formed over millions of years. It features sand dunes of seven distinct colors: red, brown, yellow, and purple, with some violet, blue and green. The colors are a result of varying mineral contents in the soil and is unlike anything I've seen before. The vibrant hues create a breathtaking mosaic. It's like nature's own abstract painting. The shades shift and blend, creating a surreal and otherworldly experience. So the admission to the seven-color earth also includes two other attractions. The first one is a tortoise park. We'll go see some tortoise. These magnificent creatures came from Adaba in the Seychelles, and they have an average lifespan of more than 150 years. Apparently, the oldest giant tortoise had lived for 250 years here. They are the second largest species of tortoise in the world, and they are the cousin of the native tortoises here, which have gone extinct since the early 18th century. If you've enjoyed exploring the wonders of Mauritius with me today, don't forget to show some love by hitting that like button. It does mean a lot to me. I've got a lot more exciting videos for my adventures in Mauritius, as well as a lot of other travel content. So make sure you subscribe to my channel. But after visiting the seven color earth, make sure you visit the waterfalls, the tallest single drop waterfall in Mauritius, measuring 100 meters high. Fed by the waters of three distinct streams pouring into Saint Denis River, the Chamarel Waterfall has a powerful rush with a peak flow rate in excess of 40,000 cubic meters per minute. The falls are beautiful, dropping into a large amphitheater, flanked by dark volcanic rock and surrounded by lush greenery. As we continue our journey, the road takes us through Black River Gorges National Park. We won't be hiking in the national park, but we'll stop by a couple of interesting viewpoints to see some of the most breathtaking views of Black River Gorges. The one you shouldn't miss is the Gorges viewpoint, where you can get a great view of the Black River Gorge. Black River Gorges is Mauritius' first national park, and its terrain is characterized by dense rainforests, spectacular canyons, and cascading waterfalls. Just flew my drone up there to capture some amazing view. So we have come to the second viewpoint in the Black River Gorges National Park. It's the Alexandra Falls viewpoint. Let's go ahead to find out. Alexandra Falls is known for its picturesque setting amidst lush greenery and rugged terrain. The waterfall cascades down a series of rocky cliffs, creating a mesmerizing sight. Right, we have one more place to visit this afternoon before heading to the hotel. We'll be visiting Grand Bassin next. Grand Bassin is a natural lake within the crater of an extinct volcano. It's also known as Ganga Talao, which means Lake of the Ganges, and is the most sacred Hindu pilgrimage site in Mauritius. And as the name implies, it's believed to be connected to the sacred Ganges River in India. The lake is surrounded by lush greenery and offers a serene and picturesque setting. On approach to the lake, you can find two towering 33 meters high statues standing on either side of the road. The one on the left is Goddess Durga, while the one on the right is God Shiva. Hindus come here regularly to pray in the temples around. As the sun sets, it's time to drive to our hotel for the night, Hilton Mauritius Resort and Spa. We'll stay here for just one night before heading off to Club Med Darbion for a week-long all-inclusive holiday. Earlier in the day, we dropped our luggage at the hotel, but our room wasn't quite ready. It certainly should be now. It's rather dark now, so I will show you more of the hotel when it's daytime. But for now, after freshening up, we're off to Le Coquillage, one of the hotel's on-site restaurants, for dinner. The dining experience here is extraordinary. To start, we indulge in truffle risotto with mushrooms and parmesan foam. The dish is as visually stunning as it is delicious.
For our main courses, we've opted for the roasted lamb rack and the succulent pork belly, both exceeding our expectations. Afterwards, the restaurant also surprised us with a birthday cake for Steve, as it was Steve's birthday. It was a really appreciated gesture. After dinner, we watched some of the evening entertainment at the hotel, featuring traditional Mauritian dancing. It was the perfect end to a perfect day. The next morning, after a restful sleep, we were eager to explore more of the hotel. Breakfast is served at La Pomme d'Amour restaurant, and it's a buffet, and the food quality is pretty good. As a resort hotel, I don't think there is enough to do here for a whole week, but for a short stay, it's perfect. We particularly enjoyed the infinity pool. It just looks so gorgeous and is well located. And of course, the best thing about the hotel is its location. You've got direct access to the famous Flic-en-Flac Beach, which is the widest, the longest, and some argues the best beach in Mauritius. Fringed with pine trees and stretching over 8 kilometers of powdery white sand and crystal clear turquoise waters, this beach is a very popular destination in Mauritius. Its calm, shallow lagoon waters make it ideal for swimming and snorkeling. Our final destination in this video is the Blue Bay Marine Park. Located on the southeastern side of Mauritius, Blue Bay was declared a marine park in 1997. Famous for its remarkable coral garden and abundant sea life, Blue Bay Marine Park is considered to be the best snorkeling spot in Mauritius. Blue Bay Beach itself is nice enough as a swimming area, but for the best snorkeling, to see the best preserved parts of the reef, with the most beautiful coral and sea life, then you need to get a boat tour from near the jetty. You'll find many operators there, and they will ask for around 1,500 rupees per person.
We just chartered a water taxi to go out to the marine park. Let's go!
Many of these boats have a glass bottom, so if you prefer to stay dry, you can still see the corals from the boat too. By the way, Blue Bay is just next to the international airport. I even captured this footage of a plane landing while I was in the water. I spent around 40 minutes snorkeling in the marine park, and I was mesmerized by the beauty of the corals and the colorful array of fish. But as they say, a picture is worth a thousand words, so I'll let you experience it for yourself.
right? It's magnificent.
I hope you've enjoyed watching this video. And guess what? Our adventures in Mauritius are just getting started. Make sure to hit that subscribe button to follow us as we continue our Mauritius trip at Club Med La Plantation d'Albion. Until next time, ciao!